A very good morning to all the students of class 4th. I am your computer teacher Jyoti. In yesterday's class we have completed our chapter 3, History of Computers. We have read the calculating devices like abacus, Napier bones, Pascal's machine, and after that we started learning about the generation of computer, who is the father of computer. Our generation includes 5 generation. We all have discussed about all the generations and the calculating device and computers. So today we have to complete the exercise of this chapter. I am going to share you this PDF so that you can complete your copies, and keep in mind that I am going to take your test on first or second week of this month, May, coming month May, and I will take your test in your lecture, so be prepared for that. You have to prepare just chapter 1 of computer. So before starting the exercise, let's begin this chapter again so that it will be a quick revision for you. So in history of computer we study about the abacus, which was invented in China. It was a calculating device and it is used for doing addition and subtraction. Is it clear to you? If someone asks you for which purpose abacus was used, so it was used in addition and subtraction. It was a calculating device. Next, come to Napier bones. It was invented by Sir John Napier in 1617. He was a mathematician and he was from Scotland. The Napier bones was made up of rods. It was made up of rods, and those rods were made up of bones. Used for multiplication of complex numbers. Okay, Napier bones was used for the multiplication of complex numbers. Then we studied about Pascal's machine. See, this is Pascal's machine. I also showed you a picture of Pascal's machine. We also call it Pascaline. It was invented in 1642 by Blaise Pascal, and it was a calculating machine, and it contains wheels, gear and dials, three things which included in it, that is wheels, gears and dials. It is used for doing mathematics. Now, Babbage's analytical engine. In 1833, Lord Babbage, or we can call him Charles Babbage. We call him Lord Babbage because he is known as father of computer. That is why his name is Lord Babbage, but his real name is Charles Babbage. At that time in 1833, he invented analytical engine, and that engine looks like this. This was the perfect computer because it contains input unit. It has a central processing unit, output unit and storage devices. That is why this is the first computer, and the person who invented this is Charles Babbage. Now, from this point our first generation started. I told you to correct the generation here. In first generation, it is from 1945 to 1956. So in our first generation, we have used vacuum tubes in computers, and low level of programming language was used, or we can call it machine language also. The size of these computers are so large that they occupy a space of room, a big room. They were so large, so huge, and they were so expensive. At least 17,000 to 18,000 vacuum tubes were used in such kind of computers. And the example are UNIVAC and ENIAC. नेक्स्ट अवर सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर यूज्ड ट्रांजिस्टर्स. दे वर सो स्मॉलर एज कम्पेयर टू वैक्यूम ट्यूब्स एंड द साइज ऑफ सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर इज स्मॉलर देन द फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर. दे वर मोर फास्टर चीपर एंड द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस इज IBM 1401. इट इज गिवन एट द बॉटम ऑफ योर बुक. नाउ इन थर्ड जनरेशन वी वर इंट्रोड्यूस टू इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट्स. दीज आर लाइक चिप्स एंड ट्रांजिस्टर वर रिप्लेस्ड बाय दीज इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट्स एंड द मटीरियल यूज्ड इन दीज इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट्स वर सिलिकॉन, मेड अप ऑफ सिलिकॉन. सो एंड नाउ द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर गिवन इन योर बुक इज यूनिवैक 1100. एंड ऑल्सो यू शुड नो वट इज़ द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर, सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर एंड थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर एंड सो ऑन. बिकॉज इन योर एक्सरसाइज इट विल आस्क यू एंड एनी वन कैन आस्क यू इन फ्यूचर वट वॉज द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ थर्ड जनरेशन, फर्स्ट जनरेशन, सेकेंड जनरेशन एंड सो ऑन. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू फोर्थ जनरेशन कंप्यूटर. वी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड टू माइक्रो प्रोसेसर्स इन दिस जनरेशन. नाउ अ स्मॉल चिप विच कैन बी टेकन इन टू अवर हैंड वर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड एंड वी कॉल दैम माइक्रो प्रोसेसर्स. दे हैव द लार्ज स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी. नाउ अवर कंप्यूटर्स आर मोर पावरफुल जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट माइक्रो प्रोसेसर. ओके, वी कैन शेयर द रिसोर्सेज एंड वी कैन कनेक्ट अवर सिस्टम टू द इंटरनेट. इन दिस जनरेशन अवर पर्सनल कंप्यूटर्स एंड डेस्कटॉप कंप्यूटर्स वर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. नाउ कम टू फिफ्थ जनरेशन कंप्यूटर. द जनरेशन इन विच वी आर लिविंग इज द फिफ्थ जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स एंड द कमिंग जनरेशन इज ऑल्सो इन फिफ्थ जनरेशन एंड देयर विल बी अ लॉट ऑफ जनरेशंस इन फ्यूचर ऑल्सो. इट विल नॉट बी लिमिटेड अप टू फिफ्थ जनरेशन. एंड दिस जनरेशन इज बेस्ड ऑन टोटली आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. आई गेव यू एन एग्जाम्पल यस्टरडे दैट द वॉइस रिकॉग्निशन विच वी आर यूजिंग इन अवर फोन्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एट गूगल वॉइस रिकॉग्निशन, फ्रॉम देयर गूगल रिकॉग्नाइज दैट वट द यूजर एक्चुअली वॉन्ट्स, देन ही प्रोसेसिज इट इन टू टेक्स्ट फॉर्म एंड गिव यू द रिजल्ट. एंड एलेक्सा, देर इज़ अ डिवाइस एलेक्सा विच यू हैव सीन, that is also an example of voice recognition. You ask her to play that song or anything, she will do that. She will play according to your demand. Okay, so this comes under fifth generation. And this generation is also developing, it is developing a new technique, a new or advanced technology day by day. This is our fifth generation. Now come to your exercise. In this you have given to complete this table. In this you have given computer generations, their time period and which kind of technology were used then. So in first generation you have to correct this. It is also given in your book. So you have to write here 1945 to 1956. And I told you in first generation vacuum tubes were used. In second generation, our time period was 1956 to 1963. And which technology was used? Transistors. See, in third generation, our third generation was from 1964 to 1971. And the technologies which were used there was integrated circuit, given at the top of this page. After that, which was from 1971 and it is also in present, microprocessors were used then, and today also we are using such computers that contains microprocessor, like we have such CPU which are in our computer lab also. Whenever school will remain will open, I will take you to the lab and will show you obviously. Now see the fifth generation, present and beyond. Present, and in coming generations or in coming time we are going to use fifth generation. After that a lot of generation will come in future. It will not limit up to fifth generation. A lot of generation will come. So which kind of technology we are using today? It is artificial intelligence. You can see the spelling of artificial intelligence from this page, page number 12 given in your book. Now tick the correct answers. The earliest human made calculating device was, so which was the very first calculating device which was human made and a calculating device given in your book? It was abacus. So you have to tick abacus here, abacus. Okay, now let's move to another one. The first machine invented by Babbage was, we study about Babbage's analytical engine, so our answer will be Babbage's engine. So its answer is analytical engine. Next, Sir John Napier invented a new calculating device using a set of rods made from bones called, see the answer is within the question, Sir John Napier. So he is asking, so this question is asking that he invented a calculating device which were made up of bones. So Napier invented it with the help of rods which were made up of bones. So its answer is Napier bones, this one. In the last, ENIAC was the first electronic computer to, in your book, in the first generation, see that example is given of ENIAC. So in first generation, if it is our first generation computer, then it obviously use vacuum tubes. So our answer will be the first one, use of vacuum tubes on large scale. Finished. Now I have question answers also for you. These are the answers of your question given in this PDF. So who is known as the father of computer science? Lord Babbage, or we can call Charles Babbage. Both will be correct. Next one, write the advantages of fourth generation computer. In fourth generation computer, it is in present and it has started in 1971. It has already started from 1971. So we have to tell the advantages. These were general purpose computer, means for, we can use them for our general purpose. Generally they can be used because at homes, at schools, at a lot of places computers were introduced in this generation because they were so cheaper, so smaller in size, portable. Okay, all these are advantages of it. And the last one, much faster than old generations. Last one is, write a short note on fifth generation computer. So presently we are using fifth generation computer, which is artificial intelligence, and still in development applications which are used in this generation, like voice recognition, which is being used today. And I have given an example in this answer, that voice recognition like thing we are using in this generation, and this generation is based upon artificial intelligence. Now your chapter has completed. You have to revise chapter 1 with its question answer, take the correct answer, true, false and all. I am going to take your test in first week of May in your lecture. So be prepared for that and keep learning about computer You can take the help of Google also, or you can contact me anytime if you have any kind of problem in any question answers or exercise, or if you have any kind of doubt. Okay, now revise this chapter and complete your copies and send me regular PDF of your work. Till now I have not received a single copy from your class, so don't be careless and share your copies with me. Make a PDF of it. Do not send directly image to me. Just make a PDF, send it to me. I will check it and prepare for test regularly. Take care. Bye bye.